Hi everyone! In this video, we're going to learn about different types of data. Data can be either qualitative, another name for that is categorical, or quantitative, another name for that is numerical. And quantitative data can be either discrete or continuous. Let's learn about each type. The difference between qualitative and quantitative data is the following. Qualitative data consists of names, labels, or categories. On the other hand, quantitative data consists of measurable quantities. It's going to be easier to understand the difference between these two types of data if we look at the examples. Let's start with examples of quantitative or numerical data. Remember, that's the one representing measurable quantities. So the height in inches of a person represents quantitative data, since height is used to measure how tall a person is. Following the same logic, it's now easy to see why the weight in pounds of a cat also represents quantitative data. And the last example is the number of siblings a person has. This represents quantitative data because the number of siblings can be used to measure a family size. So these are some examples of quantitative or numerical data. Quantitative or numerical data are always expressed by numbers and have accompanying units of measure, inches, pounds, dollars, that are important to note. Next, let's look at the examples of qualitative or categorical data. This data consists of names, labels, categories. The major of a student is an example of qualitative data. It consists of different major names. The color of a car is another example of qualitative data. The area code of a phone number also represents qualitative data. But why? Because, well, it's a number. Well, we always have to think whether we use that number to measure anything or not. So in this case, we're not really measuring anything with an area code, right? That's just three digits assigned to a certain area, so it's actually a label. So be careful here and remember that categorical or qualitative data sometimes coded with numbers that are replacing names. Always ask yourself, can I measure anything with these numbers? If the answer is no, well, then it's going to be qualitative data. Now let's go back to quantitative data and learn how some quantitative data is discrete and some quantitative data is continuous. What is the difference? Well, discrete quantitative data have gaps between successive possible values. And continuous quantitative data can take on any value between two possible values. As always, it's going to be easier to understand what it means by considering a few examples. Here's the first example of discrete quantitative data, the number of pets a person has. Well, what are the possible values? 0, meaning no pets, 1, 2, 3, and so on and so forth, with no values in between, right? You don't really want to picture 1.5 pet. So that is an example of discrete quantitative data. Another example is the shoe size a person is wearing. Well, don't think that discrete quantitative data always has to come in whole numbers. No. When we think about a shoe size, well, we know that it can be size 8, it can be size 9, it can be size 8.5. But will you be able to find in the store shoe size between 8 and 8.5? No. Well, that's what we call a gap between successive possible values. There is no possible value between 8 and 8.5 when it comes to shoe size. And the last example of discrete quantitative data is the cost of a gallon of milk. Now, I want to recommend when you're trying to determine whether you're looking at discrete or continuous quantitative data, just give yourself examples. So when I think about possible values for the cost of a gallon of milk, I can give myself an example, let's say $3.50. What would be the next possible value? Well, it has to be $3.51. And there is no possible value between those two. And therefore, the cost of a gallon of milk represents the discrete quantitative data. Now let's look at some examples for continuous quantitative data. According to the definition, it can take on any value between two possible values. The first example is the speed in miles per hour of an airplane. And here are some examples, 400 miles per hour, 401. Now between those two, I can think of 400.5, or between 400 and 400.5, I can think of 400.25, right? So no matter which two numbers you give me, I can always think of number that's in between if I just continue increasing the number of decimal places. Following the same idea, we can see why the weight of a large pizza would be continuous quantitative data, and the temperature in degrees Fahrenheit of a person. No matter which two values you give me, I can always find a decimal that would fit in between. So these are the examples of continuous quantitative data. And now as we move on in our studies of statistics, we're going to see that qualitative and quantitative data are organized and analyzed differently, and majority of the statistics course will be dedicated to quantitative data. And since we just learned that it can be either discrete or continuous, those two types of quantitative data will also be approached differently. So that's what we're going to learn in the near future.